this video lecture, we are going to look at prolonged QT interval in ECG and conditions causing that. Let's look at a question. In which condition the following type of ECG is seen? So, and the options are hypokalemia, hypercalcemia, hypermagnesemia, and hyperthermia. Now, the rate, let's look at the rate first. 1, 2, 3, 4, almost 5 large squares. 5 large squares means it's a rate of around 60 beats per minute. 300 by 5, it's 60 beats per minute. Let's look at the rhythm. The P wave is normal, QRS is normal. Then this is the T wave. This is P wave, QRS, T. So if we see in the rhythm strip or in other strips, there is a 1-to-1 conduction. So there is no missed beat or something like that. P, QRS morphology seems normal. One, you know, even though there is a slowing of heart, but if you see the QT interval, QT interval is normally 9 to 11, if you remember. 9 to 11 small squares, but in this case, if you see, so it's a start from the Q wave, QRS complex, to the end of the T wave. So in this, we can easily see. So 1, 2, almost 3 squares, 3 large squares, or a little less than that. So it's 14 small squares. Definitely the QT interval is prolonged. You can see, you know, in all the others also, you can see this is like, say, the T wave and this is the U wave. When there is a bradycardia, the U wave are generally becomes prominent. So it's normal. So this, again, in this, if you see, or anyone, if you see, 1, so from here, 1, 2, almost 13, 14 small squares is there. So definitely there is a QT interval increased. Otherwise, it's very difficult to find the ST segment is isoelectric in all the leads, right? So the answer would be hypokalemia, because all the other actually causes QT, does not cause much of a QT change. Now let's look further. So QT interval is beginning of the QRS complex to the end of the T wave, generally measured in D2. So it reflects the heart cardiac rate. Abnormally prolonged QT interval leads to ventricular arrhythmias, especially torsade pointis. QT is prolonged if more than 440 millisecond or 460 in case of female, and QT is short if less than 350. So 350 is 350 by 40, it's around 8. So if it is less than 8 small squares, then it is short. If it is more than 11, then it is prolonged. What are the causes? These are the most important. Any decrease in electrolyte, hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, hypocalcemia, and hypothermia. So these 4 decrease will cause myocardial ischemia, postcardial arrest, raised intracranial pressure, and congenital long QT syndrome. And finally, there is a huge list of drugs which actually causes prolonged QT interval. I'm not going to put it here, but you got an idea. So sometimes the only, you know, so the rate and the rhythm and everything seems normal. Even the cardiac axis is normal. If you see, both of them are pointing up. So cardiac axis is normal. Only thing is the QT interval is prolonged, which you can identify from the ECG.